What if I told you that the ocean is so deep, we still don't know what terrifying creatures might be lurking in the darkness. We've only explored 5% of it, leaving the remaining 95% a complete mystery. From colossal sea monsters to strange alien-like creatures, what could be hiding in the depths where no sunlight reaches? Around 71% of the Earth's surface is covered in water, forming vast and interconnected oceans that play a crucial role in regulating the planet's climate and supporting life. Scientists have classified these waters into 5 major oceans: the Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Arctic, and Southern Oceans, which together hold an astonishing 97% of the total Earth's water supply. These oceans are home to a staggering 94% of the world's wildlife, from microscopic plankton to the largest creature on Earth, such as the blue whale. Yet, despite their immense size and importance when it comes to ocean exploration, shockingly, only about 5% of the ocean has been explored and mapped in detail, leaving the remaining 95%, particularly the deep sea, shrouded in the mystery. What's even more surprising is that we have far more detailed and accurate maps of the surface of the Mars and the Moon than we do of the ocean floor on our own planet. Put this into perspective, 12 astronauts have collectively spent over 300 hours walking on the Moon, conducting research and exploring its barren landscape. In contrast, only 3 people in history have ever reached the Challenger Deep, the deepest known point in the ocean, located in the Mariana Trench, and their journey to this extreme depth lasted just 3 hours. With so much of the ocean still unexplored, scientists believe there could be countless undiscovered species, unknown geological formations, and even new sources of medicine hidden in the depths. If we have invested so much time and effort into exploring outer space, what incredible secrets might be still waiting for us beneath the waves? What secrets are hidden in the depths of our oceans? Let's find out in today's video. When you're at a beach and you look at the blue water, you can only see topmost layer of the ocean. This is called the sunlight zone, the depth to which sunlight can reach. In this area, the oceanic wildlife is the most colorful and diverse. There is a only layer of the sea where photosynthesis is possible. That is why macroalgae and phytoplankton are found here. These two living beings are the basis of the oceanic food chain. Apart from this, in this zone are the most of the things we associate with the oceans: whales, sharks, turtles, and dolphins, etc. But as we go deeper, it starts getting darker. The water absorbs 16% of the sunlight remains, and by the 100 meters, only 1% of the sunlight remains. As we go deeper still, light cannot reach beyond the depth of 1000 meters. This is why it's difficult for humans to see beyond the depths of the ocean. But after the sunlight zone, at the depth of 200 meters begins the next zone, called the twilight zone. As you know, sunlight encompasses all the colors. It is a spectrum of colors, from which the red color has the longest wavelength and blue and violet have the shortest. Water absorbs the longer wavelengths first. That's why red is the first to be disappeared, then orange, yellow, green, and finally blue and violet. Only blue and violet light reaches the twilight zone. All other colors disappear by then. And with this zone, we start seeing the weird creatures like this strawberry squid. This squid quite looks like a strawberry. One of its eyes is bigger than the other. The bigger eye helps it to see into the water at higher levels, and the smaller eye helps it see bioluminescence in the dark. This squid looks red to us because we see it when it's at shallower depths in full spectrum light. But if you look at in the twilight zone where it lives, it will be almost black because the color red doesn't reach there. If you go a bit deeper down the twilight zone, you will find bloody belly comb jelly. Once again, this looks to be a fluorescent red. In the deep seas, most creatures cannot see the color red, so to camouflage themselves, they are red in color. When this jellyfish moves, colorful lights flicker on its body. It looks like 8 rows of rainbows moving through the water. Look at this beautiful creature. It looked like a water fairy. It's called a sea angel. It's smaller than a human finger, and in the dark, its empty stomach glows. It's completely blind. But this sea angel can turn into a devil within a few seconds. Its quick tentacles help it form a trap which is impossible to escape. As soon as the prey reaches its stomach, it stops glowing. At the depth of 600 to 800 meters is the barrel eye fish, another fascinating fish. Its head is completely transparent and looks like a dome. Look at it carefully. No other fish resembles it, even in the slightest. Looking at it, you will find that its eyes must be these black dots above its nose. But actually, these green bulbs are its eyes. It's interesting that these eyes can only see upwards. So how do it track its food? Scientists tell us that it can somehow rotate its eyes. This feature feels like an alien technology. If you go deeper into the ocean, you will find this terrifying giant squid. These squids can be 13 meters long, equivalent to a two-story house. The diameter of its eyes is 25 to 30 centimeters, the size of a basketball. These are the largest eyes of any living beings on this earth, adapted to its prey in the dark waters. Come, let's go deeper. After crossing 1000 meters, the twilight zone ends and the midnight zone begins. Here sunlight doesn't reach it all. The creatures who live here are often moved between the twilight zone and the midnight zone, like the deep sea angler fishes. These fishes have a fishing pole on their head with a shiny bulb. They use this bulb to attract this prey in the dark waters. Similarly, we have this vampire squid. This is the largest remaining species of its order. All its relatives died 200 million years ago, now remains as fossils. Its 8 legs are connected to each other by a clock-like webbing. When they are stretched out, it looks like a vampire's cave. For many years, scientists assumed that vampire squid would be a dangerous predator, but in reality, it is not a bloodsucker. In fact, it eats poop. So even though vampire squid got a cool name, it doesn't actually reflect its behavior. Let's go further down in the depths. At the depth of 2000 to 3000 meters, there is a farmer who grows its own food. This is a yeti crab. This yeti actually exists. Its nickname is yeti because of the fur covering its arms, but the yeti crab is blind. Its fur is actually bacterial colonies. It forms bacteria on its hairy arms and then eats those bacteria. If you go further down the depth of 4000 meters, the midnight zone ends and the abyssal zone begins. It continues till 6000 meters below the surface level, and this zone is still vastly unexplored. The creatures found here aren't found anywhere else on Earth. The Titanic's wreck is present in this zone around the depth of 3810 meters. Some creatures living at this depth have discovered, like the Dumbo octopus. These Dumbo octopuses are possibly the cutest animals in the deep sea. Most of the sea floor is at the depth of 6000 meters, but at some places the sea is deeper than this. At such places, we call the depth of 6000 to 11,000 meters as the Heddal zone. This is the deepest part of the oceans and is still full of mysteries. Well, if you like this documentary, make sure to watch my other ones. Till then, see you next time.